Hello and welcome back to another session of your computer class, and today's topic is the internet. And you all are aware of this term. So let's begin. Today we will talk about the introduction of an internet, that is history and how does it came into existence, uses of internet, requirements of an internet connection and few terms related to internet. So let's proceed. Internet is a collection of computers connected by network cables or through satellite links. The internet allows the sharing of information and it connects millions of computers around the world. Thus, it is known as Global Wide Area Network, or it is also known as World Wide Network. It was one of the greatest inventions of the 1960s. So let's talk about the history of internet. A group of researchers was working for USA government in the 1960s, and they created a computer network with a group of computers that could keep working even if some of the computers were damaged. And in the next few years, big companies, universities, your airlines, railway lines, schools, everything joined this network, and they made a web of networks that were all connected together across the country. This web of network expanded worldwide, and thus the internet was created. Uses of internet. How and where do we use internet? For searching information and emailing, that is communicating, for entertainment, that is for playing games, listening music, watching movies, online shopping and advertisement, that is in trend these days, online learning, which is a basic necessity these days, and chatting. We can chat, share images and videos with the people from the other end of the world while sitting at our home. We can watch movies, play games, we can listen to any language music using this internet. Internet has various pages from which we can gain knowledge about the topics. That means we can do the research work for any topic that you are studying in school. We can also buy or sell things using this internet that considers as online shopping, or we can advertise, put up an advertise of what our requirements are. And what are we selling? Things required for internet connection. There are few things which are basically needed. First is your computer. Second is a modem. Its full form is modulator and demodulator. Third is telephone line. Fourth is ISP. That is a company which provides an internet to you. That is internet service provider, and a software, that is a web browser. Once you have your computer, you really don't need much additional hardware to connect to the internet. The primary piece of hardware you need is a modem, and there are few types of modem that are dial-up access use a telephone modem, DSL service use a DSL modem, and cable access use a cable modem, and satellite service uses a satellite adapter. Suppose you want to connect your computer to an internet service provider, that is ISP, using an ordinary phone line. The computer at your end needs a modem to modulate its digital signals, that means add them on top of an analog telephone signal so that they can travel down the phone line just like the sound of your voice. When computers connect to each other on the same network, it is called as local area network, or LAN, L-A-N, LAN. When multiple networks are connected with each other, it is called as wide area network, or WAN, W-A-N, WAN. And with this type of network, your home has a network router that connects to your ISP. Right, many of you must be using Wi-Fi connections, and you have seen all these things at your place. So modems are the most preferred hardware during an internet connection. And these devices have slots to insert your telephone line in it so that your internet connection works smoothly. The reliability and convenience of modem connection is basically dependent upon the type of computer, speed, and the type of modem you are using. All right. Then you have ISP. ISP these days, the most common or the most famous or familiar ISP we are using is Reliance Jio. These are the companies which provide internet connection to you. So these days people are using mobile phones also for using internet, because you have these digital and computer sort of mobile phones with you. These mobile phones are known as a small computer which can connect to a computer, which can connect to an internet. You don't actually need a computer to connect through to internet, right? These days we are working with our mobile phones, and many of you are using mobile phones only. Then we have web browser. We have already learned about this earlier also, that web browser is a software which helps you to access internet, right? What are these browsers? For example, we have Google Chrome, we have Google, we have Bing. All these are known as, these search engines are known as browsers, okay? Next, these are few important terms related to internet, that is World Wide Web, web page, web browser, home page, link or hyperlink, uniform resource locator. So let's discuss about them. What is World Wide Web? You all must have heard this term many times. We also use it while typing it in the address bar, www. World Wide Web is widely used electronic library that contains lots of information in the form of text, pictures, sound, and helps you to do research work. Next is web page. It is a single page on the website that contains information in the form of text, graphic, sound, or video. Then we have web browser. It is a software that is used to open web pages and website. That means it helps us to use or surf the internet. Homepage. Homepage is the starting page when you open any website. That means it is called the browser's homepage. A web page, it is a sort of a web page, but it is a first main page of any website. Link or hyperlink. When you click the link, the other page loads into your web browsers automatically. You must have seen this when we are surfing the internet and we are researching for any topic. So it provided with the list of topics below. And when you place your mouse cursor on that topic, that mouse cursor turns into a hand sign. That means that the term, that whatever the text is written, it has a hyperlink inserted with it. And when you click on that, it will redirect you to the other page. Then there is one last term, uniform resource locator, that is known as URL. And this URL is a unique address of every web page or a website. Whenever you click on any web page or website, in the address bar, you can check the URL. That means the address of that web page or website. So I hope you have understood these terms. If not, you can click on the terms and read about them, as these terms have hyperlink inserted on them. So, thank you.